This topic is to make a handmade rations or craft as a gift to celebrate an event. So maybe next year, during this time, you can be the TNT, so you can take this to board. Okay, and tonight, Chang Yuchun will be doing CC 7. The first level, we have 10 assignments, so this is number 7. And this assignment is objective is to research your topic. So tonight, Chang Yuchun will share with us this topic. Origami, more than just folding papers. Let's welcome Chang Yuchun.
And guests.
Good.
How was your dinner just now?
Good.
First of all, I would like to ask you all, have you all heard of the word origami?
Yes.
So basically origami is a Japanese word. Basically, origami are two Japanese words combined together, whereby ori means to fold and gami means paper. Together they combine and they mean folding of paper to form a three-dimensional object. When you talk about origami, most people will think that origami actually starts from Japan because of the Japanese word. However, according to Origami Resource Center, origami actually originated in China, as paper was invented in China by a Chinese by the name of Saizun in the year 1905. And with paper being invented, definitely people will start folding, although it has not been recorded. And how many of you still remember the day when you were trying to outdo your friend by folding the paper plane that can fly the longer distance, or folding a frog that can jump the furthest? Actually, origami is more to folding paper planes and folding paper boats, which I will share with you later now. According to Mata Lady, who is a medical specialist from North Brunswick, New Jersey, origami can actually assist children with learning difficulties. According to Mata, the main point children cannot learn is because have difficulty in learning because their self-esteem is low. And when their self-esteem is low, whenever they compete with others, they will think that they are inferior. And then also their focus point on one particular subject is relatively short. And when they can't do something, they will straight away become frustrated. However, by doing origami, we can actually help them in a way that, because origami is just basically folding of a piece of paper into some models. And this doesn't require a lot of time, whereby if you were to use glue or you use paint, like in modeling, you need the thing to dry before you can go on to your next step. But in origami, you just need a piece of paper, some instruction, and you can actually form a model, whereby this model, if we wrongly fold it, we can just flatten the paper or unfold it, and then we fold again. Other than this lady Kami Komato from the website Enso Unit, which is a self-help website, has stated how origami can remove anxiety and introduce patience. When someone is anxious, they tend to be very agitated. But if we can grab their attention into something like maybe a paper crane or paper bird, okay, and then we show them how this is done in a Of course, you wouldn't want to introduce something that's difficult earlier on. You could introduce something like a paper plane, whereby it's easier to fold, maybe 5 or 6 steps can be done. And then, when they keep on following this, they'll become more patient. At the same time, you can also ask them to follow rules. Because in origami, you can't skip. If you skip, you might not be able to build, to fold into what you want. And next point is, okay, this person, Haji Shalat, the founder and director of Teragami, which is a center that that uses origami to help children achieve or excel in studies has stated that origami can actually get a person to read. How many of you know of children or have children that doesn't like to read or doesn't like studying? Thank you, Steven. So in origami, especially children, they'll find it that from a piece of paper, by just folding, I can get a three-dimensional thing, which is something amazing to them. It's something that's quite magical to small boys. To us, it's okay, just paper. But to them, it's something special. So, these children would definitely want to know, okay, how can I get started by folding a paper into a paper crane or into a boat? So, the parents or the teachers can actually utilize this point whereby they just write simple instruction for the children to follow. Because being a children, when they have to do something, they will focus on it. And we give them a piece of paper, they will have to go through the paper, understand the words, which will add to their vocabulary, and then at the same time, it will also get the children to read on their own, rather than us forcing them or they doing the reading on our, rather than they doing the reading because they have to please us. Okay, now that you all know already, okay, what origami? Now that you all know, origami can actually be more than folding paper, whereby it can assist children in overcoming their difficulties in learning and to remove our anxiousness and learn to be more patient. And also as a tool to instill reading habits in both children and adults, I sincerely urge you all to try to use origami as a way to instill the following into yourself or maybe to your beloved one, so they can really think as a try. And in order to kickstart you all, I've passionately folded some paper cranes for you all, whereby if you unfold it, you get the instruction manual inside. That's all for you.